Call me now. Don't wait till summer or fall, because our schedule is filling up. So are the flies. Call us today at 410-356-2525 or visit our website, greensolutionsmd.com. When you're faced with a heating or cooling problem, do like so many of your neighbors and turn to the experts. Arundel Cooling, Heating and Electrical, Interior. ArundelCooling.com.
Oh, long time no see.
It's me.
The rock t-shirt in the back of your closet. Dude, remember? Crowd surfing me, man.
But you haven't worn me in forever.
I got it. You're tired. Last of it's a rock lifting. So take me to Goodwill. Rock can really make a difference.
Your donations to Goodwill create jobs, training programs, and education assistance for people in your community. To find your nearest donation center, go to goodwill.org. Donate stuff. Create jobs. A message from Goodwill and the Ad Council.
This portion of news brought to you by Horizon Services for all your heating and plumbing needs.
You are a hero. You may not fight killer robots, but a crabby toddler can be a formidable foe. Luckily, you're armed with a Chrysler Pacifica. Its best-in-class Uconnect theater can defeat any temper tantrum. And when cargo space is in danger, Pacifica's trusty class-exclusive stow-and-go always comes to the rescue. Get a great deal at the Chrysler Incredible Sales Event.
Available feature based on the FCA US LLC premium events of Chrysler and Uconnect with trademarks of FCA US LLC.
This is WBAL News Now with Brian Neiman, Baltimore's choice for news, traffic, weather, and stimulating morning conversation on WBAL WIYY HD2 Baltimore.
Clouds, fog, and a little bit of everything. Good morning, I'm Bill Vanko on WBAL Deja Vu in Ellicott City. That up for ABC News.
From ABC News, I'm Dave Patcher. The search is on this morning for a missing person after devastating floods ripped through a Maryland city just outside of Baltimore. ABC's David Curley is in Ellicott City.
It's a devastating flood. More than 8 inches of rain in less than 3 hours have caused this flood. The county executive says his heart goes out to the city. Many people had just rebuilt some of their businesses here. And he says this storm was worse than the one 2 years ago that devastated downtown
and caused millions of dollars worth of damage. Florida's Gulf Coast is ready for Alberto, the first named storm of the season to come ashore. ABC News senior meteorologist Rob Marciano is in the Florida Panhandle in Panama City.
There have been evacuations in Franklin County to our south here in Bay County. They're opening up shelters to take on those people that are moving away from low-lying areas.
President Trump heads to Arlington National Cemetery to mark Memorial Day. In a message this morning, President Trump remembered Memorial Day of last year when he met a young man named Christian Jacobs.
Christian was standing over his father's grave, saluting. It was something I'll never forget.
White House officials are at work now trying to restart the president's summit with North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. ABC Chief White House Correspondent Jonathan Carr.
U.S. delegations now out in the field working on this. There's the one meeting with the North Koreans in North Korea trying to see what they're going to agree on. There's also another U.S. delegation right now in Singapore working on the logistics of the summit.
Evacuations have been ordered in Hawaii ahead of some fast-moving lava from one of the vents opened up by the Kilauea volcano. There are also worries about lava hitting a power plant on the Big Island. Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is now calling for a new investigation into the assassination of his father, Bobby Kennedy, nearly 50 years ago. You're listening to ABC News.
This is a WBAL News update on WBAL News Radio 1090 and the WBAL app.
At 9:02, good morning, I'm Bill Vanko. Here's the latest from the WBAL 24-hour broadcast center. In history that didn't just repeat itself, it outdid itself in Ellicott City. We're being told this morning the damage from yesterday's monsoon was even worse than what happened not quite 2 years ago in the last round of severe flooding in the old historic Main Street area. WBAL's Scott Wyckoff is there as officials and business owners begin surveying the damage and wondering for the second time in recent memory, where do we go from here, Scott?
Yeah, that's what our county executive Alan Kittleman's doing right now here this morning, confirming his worst fears from yesterday that the devastation, the extent of the devastation, worse here yesterday from the raging river that Main Street was turned into from just 22 months ago when it was historic devastation here in Old Ellicott City. And we now know of a missing person, a man formerly of the Air Force, now a sergeant with the Maryland National Guard. That, according to the county executive.
I learned when I came here this morning, I went on for a few hours, that we have one missing person who has been reported. The individual's name is also put on the Howard County Police Department's website, so I can release that to you. If anyone has any information about this gentleman, his name is Edison Herman, H-E-R-M-O-N-D. Edison is E-D-D-I-S-O-N. He was actually reported missing to the Howard County Police Department at 12:30 this morning.
And his friends say that he went into the water near the Tiber River trying to rescue people and help get them out of here safely. Bill, I'm right here on Ellicott Mills Road where there's about a 25-foot hole in the road, the Tiber River rushing right under it. It ended up wiping out the old historic courthouse and leaving about two dozen cars and SUVs in parking lot F right next to me under mud.
Scott, I remember very clearly on the Monday morning after that last round of flooding, you and I stood at that very spot and talked about the scope of the devastation together after that round. Compare this to that in terms of what you can see from there.
Basically, this area right across from the judge's bench, this parking lot half right at the foot of St. Luke's Church, was almost untouched by the storm with damage. The only thing that was washed away was the grass and some of the mud on the hill below St. Luke's Church. That was replaced with rocks 2 years ago. Now, you wouldn't even recognize this area. That's why Howard County Executive Alan Kittleman is saying that this is worse than 2 years ago because of the additional damage that is here on the top end of Main Street, because there is the same damage on the lower end of Main Street that we saw 22 months ago.
WBAL Scott Lockout live in Ellicott City. Some of the big that had been destroyed or damaged in that last round of flooding in 2016 had just managed to reopen within the last few months. Some of those business owners tell us today that they are done now. They won't be able to rebuild again. Maryland Secretary of the Environment, Ben Grumbles, was likely the first government official to see the damage on Main Street, because he was there when it happened. He was walking on Main Street with his wife. They took shelter in a store where the rains hit and watched what was happening as Main Street became a river.
The water just trees and cars, but also trash cans and anything and everything started moving down. It was just such a powerful reminder of the force of nature and the need to think upstream and embrace smart growth, flood-proofing, and resilience.
Believe it or not, there could be more rain in the not-too-distant future as the remains of subtropical storm Alberto make their way north toward us later in the week. Taylor Griffin will be along with the full forecast coming up. And C4 talks about Ellicott City and what happened yesterday and where we go from here coming up next on WBAL News Radio 1090.
Spring. Baseball season, more time outdoors. I love it. The kids have played ball in the yard for hours, just like I did growing up. This year, I can watch them from our brand new deck from Longfence. I just went to longfence.com for a free estimate. Before you know it, we have a beautiful raised platform deck giving me a better view of the ballgame. And me, I'm just up here waiting on deck. Visit longfence.com today.
Your Horizon Services team knows that if your AC was a car, it could rack up about 27,000 miles each year trying to keep your home comfortable. Just like an oil change, your air conditioner needs maintenance too. Warm up your AC for the season with a Horizon Services $49 professional tune-up backed by an industry-leading money-back guarantee. Schedule your summer AC tune-up in the month of May and get an electric or gas heater tune-up for only $19. To receive this great offer, mention BAL Radio when you call 800-999-1995 or visit horizonservices.com.
Radio
1095 southbound at the rest area south of Route 32. An overturned tractor trailer blocking the exit lane into the rest area while two lanes are open. The interstates are good. Basically around the city you may find a little bit of fog in some spots, some wet pavement where the roads are getting some drizzle right now. It is the stretch of Main Street Frederick Road closed off between the intersection with Rogers Avenue on the Howard County side, River Road on the Baltimore County side because of all the storm damage. I'm Jim Ross, WBAL News Radio 1090.
WBAL TV 11 weather.
Looking all the skies throughout most of today, cloudy and cooler. 30% chance for a nightly to shower, high 74. Mostly cloudy tonight with low temperatures into the 60s. Partly cloudy, warmer, and the driest day of the week on Tuesday, high 85. I'm meteorologist Taylor Grandel on WBAL News Radio 1090.
Gray and damp out there this morning with lots of fog warm spread around the area. Temperatures in the low to mid-60s. 63 downtown at the Science Center, 64 at the Naval Academy in Annapolis, 61 degrees here on TV Hill. Listen to WBAL on your smart speakers. Say Alexa, enable WBAL to hear us on your Amazon device. At 9:08, I'm Bill Banco on WBAL News Radio 1090.